I was praying for you, and the Lord gave me a scripture for you, and I want to read that to you, and I want to tell you what the Lord said about that scripture. He gave me Joshua 3:16, and that says, the water, well, let me just kind of fill you in. Israel is standing by the Jordan River. The Jordan River is full. It's harvest time. It's full, and it's impassable. But the Lord instructed them with some things to do. He told the priest to carry the Ark of the Covenant, step into the water, and then Joshua 3:16 says, the water above that point began backing up at a great distance away at a town called Adam, which is near Zarethan. And the water below that point flowed onto the Dead Sea until the riverbed was completely dry. And then all the people crossed over near the town of Jericho. And, you know, the people had come, God had called them to enter into the promised land. And they were just at that point, but there was a huge obstacle standing in their way. And so they needed a miracle from God to be able to get to the other side into the promises that God had promised them. And so God instructed them what to do. And, you know, some of us are in very similar situations. It seems like we're in a season of the impossible. But God says, no, listen carefully. It is not impossible. Just look and see what he did. And he wants to do the same thing for you. He's taking you on a journey. He's made promises to you. He's not going to leave you out in the middle of nowhere with no way to enter into the promises. And so he will take you. He's going to remove the roadblocks and take you through so that you can get to the things that he has promised you. So this is what God says to tell you, that listen to him very carefully. He is going to give you a plan on how to enter into the promises. He said, ask him. Listen, obey carefully to what he tells you to do, and watch what he will do as he removes the obstacles out of your way so you can enter into what he has promised you.